lights.
HDR is also in the metropolitan area of New York City. I'm in a major office up in Rockland County. We used to be LMS engineers. We've got an office over in New York. We've got one down in Trenton. Up in the Hudson Valley. New York City office is transportation
related
in engineering.
Sorry.
Well, the river is water. That's been my interest. Primary interest.
But I attended the meetings where they were making the decision first on what to do about it. We're having an expo.
That's what you guys are interested in.
Ben Davis, Steve, please. Get in touch. Company A as a subsidiary of Company B. Company B purchased property until it guarantees its
contract with the
Company B will not purchase the land and allow Company A to do work on the subcontracts until Company B figures out if they have a contract or not. So the point of the
So this nexus here, which says, we have found sort of the sweet spot or the balance between environmental issues, between societal issues, and between economic issues. And we want to move from saying those three things are somehow in competition to saying, how do we find a place where they are actually synergistic, right? How does taking care of business also take care of the environment? How does taking care of our communities also take care of business? You know, how does doing that mean that the other ones also benefit, right? Because that's how you create a sustainable answer. And for any society to work, we've got to find these solutions. All of the solutions ultimately fail to really work over time. So what we're going to ask you today is to think about and reflect on your experience in waterfront planning and waterfront development and working on waterfront issues, and think about where have you not been doing that and why, but more important is how do we find that? And I'm going to close with a very specific question. What constructive and positive actions, right? So we want to be very action-oriented. We want to say, what can we do, right? What are the things that we can do that will help us find that hidden synergy, promote that hidden synergy in waterfront planning and development, right? Those might be what relationships need to be strengthened or developed. What specific kinds of programs or actions can we develop or take? What specific kinds of planning events and or activities? What changes in rules, regs, and policies would help create this synergy between those three elements of and as you're doing this, I want you to think about how you're relating to each other. You're going to be in groups of three or four. You're going to be having these small conversations. I want to make sure you're focusing on what matters. Don't just rehash all this stuff. You know, don't just complain. Really think about what matters on the waterfront. What matters to us as a city, as a community, in trying to get a more vitalized and excited waterfront. When you're not talking, listen. These small groups are really focused on, you know, hearing viewpoints different from yours, hearing perspectives that are new or different to you in terms of how this works. Build on what you hear, play off each other. You know, really think about, you know, try to think outside the norm, outside the status quo, outside the box, if you will. And dig deep as you think, as you move from group to group. You know, I want you to dig deeper and deeper into issues and think about things at a deeper level. Also, take responsibility. If all you're going to sit there and say, well, everything will be great as long as they change, right? As long as somebody else does something. Think about, what can I do? What can my group do? How do I contribute to change or intermediate activities? And definitely explore what it will take to make it work here, right? Knowing this waterfront, this world that we live in. Don't plan for the ideal world. Don't plan for the perfect world. It does not exist. Think about what are the actions we can take for this world, for New York City, for New York City's waterfront, that could have a constructive and positive change. The way we're going to do this is each group has a couple of clipboards there with just plain white paper. I have more white paper. So you can generate as many ideas as you have thought to do. And what I want you to do is using the markers, on each time you have an idea, an action, or a step, or something constructive that you take, write it on a piece of white paper in big letters, because we're gonna post all of these, but one idea per sheet. In other words, if your group has generated 20 ideas, you should have 20 sheets of paper, not 20 ideas on. So this way it's going to help us organize these ideas, think about these ideas when all is said and done. So the way this works is each group, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to identify a group facilitator. Facilitators, that means that you're going to stay in that circle the whole time. Everybody else is going to leave you, okay? So you're going to stay there, and your job is to make sure that group's knowledge is captured. Okay. Make sure those ideas get put on sheets of paper. And make sure everybody talks and everybody talks. But you are also part of the group. You're not holding yourself out from the group.
you're sharing your ideas and your thoughts, but you have that extra job of making sure everything gets written down. You don't have to write it yourself, you just have to make sure they get written down. Okay? And then when we're all done, we're going to take all those ideas and we're going to get them up on this wall. This is what's called a sticky wall. Our papers will just stick up there. We're going to be able to kind of get all of our ideas up there, organize them, categorize them, and then we'll do a real quick priority to say, out of all those ideas, they're all good ideas, but here's some ones that we think are either going to be most effective or are most important to us in trying to do action. Okay. So once we get started, I'm going to give you probably about 15 minutes in the group you're in now, then I'm going to call time. Right? Facilitators, you're going to stay where you are, and then everybody else, you're going to move to different circles. So then you're going to be in a new circle, and you're going to be with all new people you haven't had a conversation with, and we're going to continue the conversation. Right? And each time you switch, you're going to find talking to new people, hearing new perspectives, digging a little deeper, and looking at some issues in a little more variety of perspective. Okay? We'll probably switch about three or four times. We're going to leave ourselves about half an hour, 40 minutes, to collect everything at the end and put it up. Okay? Any questions about what we're doing? Yeah, facilitators, and I'll reiterate that as we go. But you, the first thing you do is figure out who's going to be the facilitator. That means you're at that circle the whole time. Okay? Everybody else is going to move. You're going to stay. And other people are going to come to you at the break. Any other questions? Okay.
Give us an example.
An example of what you might say? You're thinking about different sectors of society that need to work together more effectively. Right? So one clear example would be, how do we create better communication? How do we build relationships between the business community, the environmental community, and the community, right, to have the conversations they need to have about waterfront planning and waterfront development, right? So where can those relationships actually be built? Who would build them? How would they be created? How would they be sustained? You know, you guys know the communities, you know these people. We're looking for ideas of how that might work. That's one example. Okay. Any other questions? Any other confusion? Do you understand what we're doing? Look, this really is brainstorming, too. There's no bad ideas that are going to come out of this. There's no wrong way to go. You know, we want to kind of keep your focus on that, creating that synergy and sustainability around those three sectors of society, but you can't have a bad idea. Any other questions or thoughts? All right, give it a shot. Flag me down if you have anything you need, and I'll give you about a 2 minute warning, and then we'll call time and move.
Yeah, I was about to
someone gets latched on to something. But 60 years ago, it's very people want to see the job. Sort of a, let's just complete the baby start talking about it. Take an example of the subway tunnel that was down there. See, there's no arm on that, but it's not a 21st century problem. It's not something that makes sense to anyone. But there are plenty of people who advocate that. There's too many times, is it a waste of time? It's just something that's not really understood. So maybe that's part of the education.
Thank you. I don't get why the dry house has to be put in the nursery.
Exactly. It doesn't. So,
right.
But that's what it's not intended. So if you foster the dry dock as a primary construction, and you start to say, well, okay,
you're talking to me. it's not the law.